Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we are going to explore how to integrate Azure File Share with the Active Directory authentication. So for that, first we need to have a domain controller and one client VM. So I have deployed NE-DC-01 as the domain controller, and it is deployed in North Europe, and I have a client VM that is also deployed in the North Europe location. Okay, so acgcloud.com, this is the domain that we are using here for the testing. And now I'm going to create a new user account here. So let me create a new user. acgadmin. Okay, so I have created the ACG admin account, and I'm going to make a member of domain admin. And enterprise admin. And schema admin. Okay, and then I'm going to log into the domain controller with this new account. And also we need to install the Azure AD Connect on the domain controller. And using the account that we have created, we can sync all the objects from the on-premise to the Azure Entra ID. So here we need to have the Azure Entra ID as well with the global administrator access, so that we can use those credential to sync all the objects from the DC to the Azure Entra ID. So let me go to the Azure Entra ID here. So here if you go to the Microsoft Entra ID and go to the users, and here we can see that ACG admin that we have just created that has been replicated to the Entra ID. Okay, so next let me go to the storage account, and here I'm going to create a new storage account. So I'm going to use the RG test resource group and ACGSA02 as the storage account name. It's going to be in the same region, and it's going to be a same standard performance. Let me review and create. Okay, so file share, the storage account has been created. Next, let me go to the storage account and expand the data storage. And here we are going to create the file share. So let me create a test file share. File share one, and click next for backup. So let's not enable the backup. And review and create. Okay, so we have created the storage account, and then we have created the file share 01. Okay, so next we are going to create the private endpoint. So under security and networking, click on networking. Under private endpoint connection, click on private endpoint. So here, give the private endpoint name, and let me keep 01. And here we can keep it in the same North Europe region. Okay, click on next, resources. Okay, here select a target sub resource. So we are creating the file. So select the file here. and click on next for virtual network. And we are going to use the existing virtual network and the default subnet here. And click on next for DNS. And we are not going to use the private DNS zone. So let's click on no. And click on next for tag and review create. Okay, so now we are creating the private endpoint for the file share. Okay, so it has been completed. Go to the resource. Okay, let me go to the storage account too and go to the file share. Okay, and go to the networking. Okay, so here click on this private endpoint. Under the DNS configuration, here we can see the custom DNS records, FQDN. This is the FQDN name for the storage account that we have created. And this is the IP address it has taken from the subnet we have selected. Okay, now let's go to the domain controller and there we have to create the new zone for this DNS record. Okay, so I'm going to create a zone in this name. So right click on the forward lookup zone and create a new zone. Click on next, 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 and here enter the zone name and next, click on finish. So here select the file share, that zone that we have created here, and here right click and create a new host, a record. And here we can see the FQDN name and the IP address. This is the IP address that is taken. Provide the IP address here and add host. Host was successfully created. And if you run the NS lookup for that a record that we have created, you can see that it is resolving with this IP address. Okay, so next let me log into the client VM that we have created. So this is the client VM and we need to disable the firewall in this client VM. Okay, and once we have disabled the firewall, we need to update the DNS for this client VM. So you have to update in the portal. So go to the client VM and go to the network settings and go to the interface, go to the DNS server, and here you need to put the domain controller IP address as the DNS server, and then you need to reboot the server to take effect this DNS server. And once the client VM is rebooted, then you can join to this acgcloud.com domain. Okay, as you can see, this is the client VM and this is joined to the acgcloud.com domain. And I have already disabled the Windows firewall. Okay, next I'm going to run few commands to create the Kerberos keys. So with that key, we will be creating the service account. And we will be using that service account for this purpose. Okay, I have already run this connect AZ account and now I'm going to run this command. Okay, and next I'm going to run this command. Okay, and next we're going to generate the Kerberos keys. Okay, I'll be copying this keys, and using this key I'll be creating the service account, and for that service account using this as the password. So let me go to the domain controller. Okay, here I'm going to create a new service account called SVC AFS. Okay, I'm copying this value to the domain controller as the password and creating this service account. Okay, SVC-AFS. And next we are going to set the SPN for the storage account, and with that service principle that we have created. So I'm going to execute this command. Okay, so we have set the SPN. And next we are going to run this get-addomain command. Let me run it on the domain controller so that we can get some details, and we will be using some of those details in our next command. For example, we'll be using the object GUID here and the domain SID. So those details we need to copy from this command. And next we will be running get AD user this command, because we will be taking the SID of this command as well. Okay, next let me copy the required command. Okay, so this command we are going to run it. So this is the name of the file share, ACG SA02. And here domain GUID, we are going to use this domain GUID. Okay, next I'm copying the SID here. Okay, and next Active Directory Azure Storage SID. So for this, I'm going to use this SID. This is for the service principal account that we have created. Now we are going to execute this portion of the command. Okay, so now we are able to run it successfully. There was some typo and space on this command while we copy paste. So I just had to, you know, put it in the notepad so that we don't space that problem. Okay, so next go to the storage account and the file share. Okay, so here we need to, you know, give the required permission. So we'll be using the contributor, the storage SMB contributor access for this file share, so that user can read, write, and modify the file. Okay, go to the IAM and here add role assignment. Okay, and here search with SMB, and the storage file data SMB share contributor. This gives access to read, write, and delete the Azure file share. And if you want to set up the reader access, you can choose this role. Okay, and click on next. And here you need to select the member. So we can select our ACG admin, the user that we have created, and click on next. ACG admin and review assign. Okay, so we have added the role. Okay, and next, under the file share, go to the file share 01, and here you can click on connect, and here you can click on show script, and this is the script that we can use to map it on the client VM. So I'm going to copy this and then log into the client VM. Okay, open the my computer and right click, map network drive. I'm going to paste it here, ACG SA02. This is the file share. Click on finish. Okay, as you can see, now we are able to successfully map the Azure file share in the client VM using the AD authentication. So now if we create any file here, let's just create some folder and test file. And now if you go back to the Azure file share, go to this file share. Okay, now you can see the files are replicated to the Azure file share. Okay, so that's it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.